Well, the hearts have been set aflutter here as Ravishing Rick Rude makes his way to the ring. Hello, everyone. I'm Sean Mooney. Joining me here in the broadcast booth, his lordship, Alfred Hayes.
Yeah, sure.
Alfred, good to see you.
Good to see you. I'm sure there's one or two young maidens enamored with him.
Now, what do you think, Alfred? Can I gyrate as well as Rick, huh?
Oh, yes, you certainly do.
I think I got a couple of maidens over here.
There they are, waving to you.
Former Olympian Ken Patera. And look at the determination on his face, Alfred.
Yes, he has awesome power, Ken Patera. And he's really determined to teach a lesson to this upstart, Ravishing recruit.
Well, he's anxious to get this match underway.
Yes, that was a nice shot over Heenan's shoulder there as we looked at his man preparing to take on this man, Olympian Ken Patera, who is acknowledged as one of the strongest men of all time ever within the ranks of the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, it has never been said that Rick Rude is, likes himself, but I think the ultimate compliment he's giving himself right there is the fact that he's wearing tights with his own face on.
Yes, definitely. But I'll say one thing for Rick Rude, he's never refused a challenge, and he's never backed away from the strongest or the fastest or the best there is within the ranks of the World Wrestling Federation. So until a time that he does, I'll reserve judgment on what beats beneath that exterior, and I'm talking about heart, of course.
Well, he certainly has not backed down from this challenge by Ken Patera.
No, he may have a narcissist attitude, but at the same time, he can mix it with the toughest.
As we see right here, Rick Rude, the side headlock on, using the other arm for the support up. But not for long. Ken Patera lifts him right up, deposits him on the top turnbuckle.
And there is a showing of that
not
incredible
sure where
strength.
He's going. He's going after Bobby Heenan. Did he change his mind there?
Well, he allowed himself to be distracted. Look at that power there. Oh, again. Rude can do nothing about that. But Patera must not be distracted by Heenan. The key to a victory here for him this evening is to take his mind off Heenan at all times and just concentrate purely upon Ravishing Rick Rude. There he is.
Well, Alfred, showing the upper body strength, that arm strength of Ken Patera right there. Rick Rude clearly had the leverage with all his body weight trying to send him across the ring and could not do it.
Could not do it. Absolutely right. And he is quite a strong man in his own right, Ravishing Rick Rude. I mean, look, he has powerful upper body development that obviously portrays a lot of strength, but not comparable to that of Ken Patera.
Well, it appears that Ken Patera is asking for a test of strength. Rick Rude wants to think about it a little, confers with his manager, Bobby Heenan.
Yes, he's probably asking him if he knows any devious tricks as far as this is concerned. And perhaps he does.
No.
Bobby Heenan, you can hear him saying no, no.
Well, we heard him quite plainly from here, so I would imagine Ravishing did.
Prompting Rick Rude to back out of the confrontation there. And once again, they're going to meet. Perhaps we will see a test of strength this time. And we do. Pretty even at this point, Alfred.
It is indeed. You know, looking at Ravishing Rick Rude, doesn't he put you in mind of Pat Patterson when he was wrestling just a couple of years ago? Yes. Uh-huh.
Well, I was going to say 40 years ago, but...
Well, it would have been about 40 years ago. Well, not exactly. That's not Pat Patterson. That's
no.
Not,
no. Rick Rude getting the best of this one right now. But Ken Patera, you see him perhaps reaching back into his weightlifting past.
That is
Looks like an overhead press right there.
Yes. Yes, and he's got that tremendous balance, which obviously comes from a long and successful weightlifting career.
After all, he wasn't going after having a couple weights dropped on his foot once or twice, he learned that move.
Yeah, a 50-pounder on your hand there. Or in Patera's fashion, a 270-pounder on your fingers. Our cameraman not averse to standing right behind the competitors here and putting us right in with that action.
They lock up once again. Kent Patera with that big left arm wrapped around the neck of Rick Rude. Rude breaks free. Right over the top. Taking out a little time to do some showboating. Turns his back on Kent Patera. And Patera has him in a massive bear hug.
It always happens when they showboat. They come unstuck. They should never do that. If Rude didn't showboat so much, I'm sure he'd be right within the ranks, equal to the world championship right now.
You can see the grimace on Rick Rude's face. Obvious to the fact that Kent Patera really has this bear hug set.
Patera getting into a better leverage position there. Meanwhile, we saw Heenan arguing with the timekeeper, telling him not to ring that bell. Of course, if he does, it's only the loser's purse for Rude, and that means a lesser percentage for Heenan. Look at him.
Well, not only the blow to his ego.
Yes. No, he's interested in money, too, believe me.
Patera still holding on, but we have gotten no submission to this point. Rude fighting his way back up.
So far, just as we expected, Sean, everything has gone in the favor of the ex-Olympian, Ken Patera. He's done so well against Rude, and Rude, in fact, hasn't looked terribly good at all. He hasn't impressed me at the moment, not one iota.
Now, referee Joey Morella looking for the submission here.
What a devious way to get out of that situation.
Well, I think that was a desperation move, Alfred.
Yes, and it also looks like a turning point at the moment, because suddenly the pendulum has swung in favor of Ravishing Rick Rude.
Flying mare. Drops the forearm across the throat and trying to do some gyrating. He may have hurt his lower back. That's a different way to find out.
Yes, it certainly is. Something's wrong with the lower sacroiliac there.
Sacroiliac?
Yeah. I think it means spine. I'm not sure.
Clothesline to go along with his back problem. Up on the second rope. Successive rights to the head of Rick Rude. As Ken Patera once again takes control. Into the corner. Trying to come in with that shoulder block. Rick Rude quickly got out of the way. Going for the Rude Awakening. Quickly pulled that one off.
Oh, my word, what an incredible situation to arrive there so fortuitously for that man.
Quick turn of events. And Rick Rude turns it around quickly and takes advantage of it and turns it into a victory. And I think we're going to get another look.
Yes, let's see exactly what happened. The Olympian Pantera was right on top here. But Rude managed to sidestep him there. He ran into that turnbuckle. And although Rude is staggering, he is quick to take advantage of this situation and nails him with that Rude Awakening, that unique move to him, and gets a very, very good 1-2-3. Well.